All right, let's get started. First thing you're going to want to do is make sure that you have a fresh copy of Schedule 1 installed on Steam. A fresh copy just means you haven't tampered with the files at all, so if you've tried installing mods and it didn't work, make sure you delete everything out of your game folder and reinstall the game again. You can also just right-click and uninstall, and then reinstall. That should be fine. A couple things I want to mention before we get started. The first thing is you'll notice that I'm playing on a beta version. You can install mods on a beta version, just keep in mind there's a lot more bugs. Now, if you want to be a part of the beta and you don't know how to, let me go ahead and show you how to do that real fast. Just right-click here on Schedule 1, click Properties, and click on Betas. You're going to change this from None to Beta, and you will notice your game will update when you do that. It will also say Beta here when it has updated, and that's how you'll know. Now, the other thing I want to mention too is anytime you install mods in Schedule 1, it will disable your achievements. You will not be able to get achievements on that save anymore. So make sure that you go into game and save on a different file to back up your save. And so that way you are not disabling achievements on a main save that you have worked very hard on. Now, once you have done that, let's go ahead and minimize Steam here. And we're going to open up a couple sites. The very first thing we need is right here. It's this site up here. This is MelonLoader. I will have all of these links down in the description below, but when you click on it, it should take you to this site. You're going to scroll down and you'll see these two green things right here. This is perfect. Now, if you're on Linux, go ahead and download this bottom one, but we're on Windows, so we're going to download this top one. You'll click on it and you'll notice it's downloaded. Once it's downloaded, click on it. It should open up and it's asking you right here which game you have installed that you want to install MelonLoader on. We want to do Schedule 1, so we're going to click that. Now, there's nothing on this page you need to change unless your game is not installed on your C drive. If your game is installed on any other drive, just click this folder and find your game. But my game is installed right here, so I'm going to click Install. And it only takes a second, and that is good to go. The next thing we're going to do is go find the mods that we want to install. And to do that, I usually go to Nexus Mods, and I'll find Schedule 1 there. I will also have this link down in the description below, and it should take you to this page. Now, usually what I do to decide which mods I want to download is I scroll down a little bit and I click on Popular. The popular mods are usually the tried and tested mods that tend to be more updated than the rest. These are usually really good mods to start out with, and I definitely recommend checking these out. I've selected 5 of these that I've been using in my own save that we're going to install right now. So the first one is Mod Manager. Now, Mod Manager is not necessarily required to get mods to work, but it is a really good way of telling whether or not your mods are working while you're in game. So to do that, we're going to scroll down. You're always going to want to read this installation right here. This will tell you where to put the file once you've downloaded it, but I know where to put it, so I'm going to show you guys right now. We're going to manual download, slow download, and we're actually going to do the same process for the rest of the mods as well. Now you can see I have everything downloaded here, which is perfect. We're going to open up our download folder. Now also keep in mind, like I said, not every mod is installed the same exact way. Most of them are installed the same way, but always make sure to check this installation part of every single mod to make sure it's installed the way that you know how to install it. If it's not, just go ahead and follow the instructions that it has below. But we're going to go ahead and minimize this real quick. We're going to open up our downloads folder that we had opened, and we're going to go ahead and click on the very first one. You're going to open this in 7-zip, WinRAR, or if your computer just opens it up, perfect. But either way, make sure you have something that you can open up a zip file or a RAR file with. Once you open it up, you will see we have this DLL file. These DLL files are very easy to manage. We're just going to go ahead and minimize this real quick. You're going to open up Steam. You're going to right-click on Schedule 1, Manage, and Browse Local Files. It should pull up this window right here. And what we're going to go ahead and do is double click on the mods folder. This mods folder right here is where most of your mods are going to be drag and drop to, especially your DLL files. If you have just a single DLL file as a mod, it will usually get drag and dropped right here into the mods folder. So go ahead and do that, and we have the mod manager installed now. We're going to go ahead and do that for the other mods as well. You will also notice in this one it gave me a folder. Now, I know the install instructions told me to just drag and drop these into the mod folder, so I'm going to do that as well. Now, I have one more mod here. This is Better Employees, and I wanted to show you guys this is a mod that is installed slightly different than the others. When you double-click on it, you'll notice instead of getting DLL files, we have two folders here, mods and user data. Now, if you go back to the Schedule 1 folder right here that has all of your files, you will notice that there is mods and user data. So we need to combine these folders. And to do that, all we're going to do is select both of them and drag them and drop them in here. If you see that a mod comes with two folders that are already in your game file, you just combine the folders. You'll notice mods right here, that's a DLL file. So that got drag and dropped right into there. And user data, we have Better Employees right there. Now, a couple of mods will come with an extra folder that has a config file in it. Those are perfect. You can double click on those. They should open up the config file right here for you. And you can change some of the values that are here to be able to customize the mod a little bit more to your liking. Just keep in mind, again, if you're running on a beta version, some things might not work as intended. So the best result when it comes to mods is going to be any official version of the game. But once we have all that, we have officially installed all of our mods, and we're going to go ahead and launch our game. And the first thing you're going to notice is you're going to have a little console window come up. Just came up right here. It's going to take a second for it to load up, and that's perfectly fine. It's just initializing everything, downloading all the correct files that it needs and all of that. You're going to give it just a minute to let this run, and it will launch the game when it's done. The other thing I wanted to say is I want to thank you all so much for watching. I know it's been a while since I've posted a video, but I am just trying to get my channel sorted out right now. So currently I'm coming out with two different types of content, and I have decided to move one of those types of content to another channel. Now that doesn't affect you guys. If you guys follow me for gaming, you will see more gaming posts here on the WitherFox channel, but all of my other content, I'm working on a second channel right now, and that's for a whole other audience. So I do want to thank everybody. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. I do videos like this as often as I can, just to show you guys how easy it is to mod games. And if you're not new to the channel and you've been subscribed for a while and waiting for new content, here it is. And I am very, very happy to show you guys this. Please double check the video description for all of the links that you need. And I will see you guys in the next video. Take care.